Hi everyone, my name is Jeevan and I'm a program manager in the Azure Identity organization at Microsoft. Today, I'm going to show you how to resolve the error: the reply URL specified in the request does not match the reply URLs configured for the application when users sign into an application. We'll start by discussing what reply URLs are. Reply URLs are also sometimes called redirect URIs, but for the purposes of this video, I'll use the term reply URL. When an application uses a modern authentication flow, it delegates the authentication and authorization to an identity provider such as Azure AD. Once that identity provider has completed the authentication or authorization, it'll send the result back to your application. The reply URL specifies the location that the identity provider should send the result to. The reply URL is specified in two places. It is included in the request the application sent to Azure AD, and also it must be included in the application registration with Azure AD. This process provides an additional layer of security, as Azure AD will prevent bad actors from intercepting your auth code or access token by altering the reply URLs. Azure AD only accepts safe reply URLs which are already defined in the Azure portal. We will look at this in more detail in the demo which is up next. Our user Alice is in the home page of the demo application and she's going to sign into the application by clicking the sign in button. She's going to now enter her credentials. However, she is unable to sign in and is presented with the error: the reply URL specified in the request does not match the reply URLs configured for the application. This is happening because of the mismatch in the reply URLs defined in the Azure portal and the reply URL the application is providing to Azure AD. Let's now go back to the sign-in experience and try to grab the reply URL passed by the application to Azure AD. We're back in the home page, and this time let's try to grab the URL after pressing the sign in button. I've copied the URL now, and let me paste it on Notepad to have a closer look. As we can see, the redirect URI or the reply URI is defined as part of the request here, and it contains https demo app prod.azurewebsites.net/signinoidc. Now we will go to the Azure portal and see if this reply URL is defined in the allow list in the Azure portal. We are now in the demo app registration in the Azure portal. Let's head over to the authentication tab. Over here we can see the allow list of reply URLs, and we can see that the reply URL which we saw earlier, which was demo app prod.azurewebsites.net, is not defined in this allow list of reply URLs, which is exactly why the user was given that error. Let's now add that reply URL here. I've added that and I'm going to click save now. We'll now go back to the application and see if the user is able to sign in now. We're back in the home page of the application and Alice is going to try to sign in again. She has entered her credentials. This time, the reply URL mismatch error is gone, as we have defined the right reply URL in the allow list and Alice is able to successfully sign in. This reply URL error scenario often happens due to miscommunications between the DevOps engineers and the administrators. For example, DevOps engineers move the application from the staging environment to production, but the administrator misses adding the production reply URL in the allow list on the Azure portal. Another instance where this error is encountered is when developers use reply URLs starting with localhost in their local machines while developing the application and misses adding that reply URL in the allow list in the Azure portal. We just looked at a frequent problem with an amazingly simple solution. I really hope it was useful for you. See you next time. Thank you.